Pisces, this is all about you. I love you, love you, love you. Okay. Let's get into your reading. This is your weekly oracle and tarot card reading from Born Without Boundaries. We're going to start with your oracle card reading, Pisces energy. So wherever Pisces influences your natal chart, you can apply these energies for the next 7 to 10 days from whenever you see this video. So it's not time stamped. No. It's not time marked at all. It'll come to you when it's supposed to come to you. But these energies generally hang around for about a week or so. So just FYI. And I always recommend if you're a Pisces sun watching this, please do check out your moon sign and please do check out your rising sign at the very least. It's easy to do. If you don't know it, then please go to astrologycafe.com and you can run a free natal chart. No, this is not paid sponsorship at all. This is simply just my recommendation because I use the site a lot and they offer a lot of free free tools for you guys. So it's really interesting. If you want to know more about yourself, it's a really good place to start. So please do. Pisces though, let's get into your energy. Remember, this is your oracle card reading. We're going to do a full energetic spread and then we're going to dive deep into messages that are more specific and articulated with the full tarot card spread, as well as the romance predictions. And those are in the extended video. That link is in the description box below. Pisces. Let spirit be your guide. No, I feel like you're going rogue. There's some sort of disconnect here from spirit. Truth cards came out. Truth transcends illusion. I think you're deep into your illusion. I don't know what Neptune is up to right now, but it's almost like you're deep in the veil, wrapped in illusion. It could just mean that you're wrapped in a dream. What I don't like is this disconnection from spirit, but it also could just be that right now you're not looking into the future. You're not looking that far forward. You really love this moment. You love being in this moment. You love being right here, right now. There's something about where you are right now that is really, really cushy, cozy, comfy for you, and you like this feeling. This is the sense of emotionally sort of being buffered right now in a sort of cloud or a dream world and not really wanting to look too far, not wanting to look ahead, not wanting to look behind, really being lost in the illusion and enjoying yourself. I don't know if you're kind of getting high a lot or you just have this energy of really, really feeling like your life is a dream. Like life could be a dream, sweetheart. And this is sort of where you are right now. Essentially, don't ask, don't tell. There's a lot of cards flipping over in reverse though. And I really don't like that. So it's a sense, what's going on, Pisces? What's going on? There's a sense of being toppled over on your head. This was supposed to be a good week for you. What's going on? No, love is all around, but this is a sense of, once again, disconnection or maybe a breakup, or then maybe that's why you're trying to feel numb, stay away from this energy of just you don't want to hear it, you don't want to know it, or somebody in your life doesn't want to hear it, doesn't want to know it, something that you don't want to realize, sort of resounding all around you, disconnected from you, taking love away from you. This could be an impending breakup. And this is give with gratitude and grace. Maybe somebody in your life was not really giving to you, was taking from you, was feeding off of you, and a sense of they sort of surrounded you in what seemed to be love, but really what they were trying to do was suck your bones dry, but not in a good way. This is a sense of sort of being manipulated for all your worth, and or feeling like you are, feeling stripped somehow, almost trying to buffer yourself emotionally. Maybe you were lost in a dream for too long, and this is the hardship of actually coming out of it. Yeah, some mask, somebody who was deceiving you is being unmasked and being revealed. There's a sense of, yes, no, truth. Okay, it's almost like you don't want to believe what you're seeing about somebody. This is not something that you want to see. You want to refuse the truth and stay in the illusion because it's hurting too bad or it's too much. But this is definitely energy of having to deal with something that you don't want to deal with, a truth that is too harsh. keeping the truth away from you, even though the truth has finally come out, like the mystery is solved. Somebody is, this is a mask dropping off, right? That's what it is getting completely and totally raw and real and seeing somebody stripped down to their bones. So that could also be what it is too, is seeing the truth about somebody. It may not be about deception, but it just seeing sort of their ugly parts, their not so good parts, or just the truth about them. The glamour is removed from them, or a circumstance. Trust in divine detours. This is a sense of being stuck, being stagnated, not knowing which way to go, feeling like you're not good enough, or you're not the right look, or you're not the right thing, or no matter what you do, the way is not forward, or that once again, it's like everybody that you trust ends up disappointing you. Oh boy, now is a lucky time. This is still an abundant time, but at the same time, it's like things aren't happening as quickly as they're supposed to. Things are not multiplying the way that they're supposed to. There's a sense of being deprived and of being separated from what you expected to happen. Ooh, okay, and then overcome any obstacle. You feel drowned, you feel upside down, the world has turned upside down, looking at things from a different perspective is impossible, you feel sort of stuck, or you're sticking to someplace, you sort of rolled over, like you refuse to believe something. This is stubbornness. It could be somebody in your life refuses to believe something, doesn't want to see something, is refusing the truth of something. This may be your energy or their energy, Pisces, but it's definitely happening. And then we have learn from the past, making the same mistakes, being stubborn, being pigheaded, not wanting to see the truth, lies, deception, being forced to remember something that you don't want to remember, or memories you've tried to repress, an energy of being bullied or bulldozered, a sense of being stampled or trampled or stampeded over, basically probably because of this truth. What is going on, Pisces? This is an energy of, oh my God, why? This is like, who is really stampeding over all of you? I don't know. It's like all of these cards are in reverse, Pisces. Maybe you just feel like your world is turned upside down, like you don't know how to react to it right now. But there was a serious disappointment, perhaps a blatant sort of, I don't know. And more fucking cards. I'm sorry. More cards, like, coming out upside down in reverse. What is going on, Pisces? A rebirth is assured. This is suspended and stuck in the chrysalis, not deciding that you don't want to come out. You don't want to be a butterfly. Be generous of spirit. Yet all of these cards are in reverse, Pisces. And no, I wasn't holding the deck in reverse. This is 100% just because all the cards literally flipped over when they came out. Pisces, I don't understand this energy, except that I have to interpret it for what it is. And essentially, this would be hashtag worst week ever. I don't want to say that, though, because these energies are basically just discussions. Let's talk about what's going on. Let's talk about what we're going through. This is definitely, you've lost your sense of self. You've lost your sense of what you deserve. You've lost your sense of progress. You're scared. You're scared to bloom and be all that you want to be. You're still holding on to some sort of delusion that tethers you to a past that wasn't even that good. It tethers you to people that weren't even that good for you. It is just such a stagnated way to not move forward. And Pisces, it's just like a fear reaction. It's almost like you're clenching in your throat. You don't want to move on. You're being denied this. You're denying yourself this progress and these opportunities, because 100% all of these cards could be like the best week ever, but there's a resistance to progress. There's either a resistance to it or a block from progress. It could, I don't know. It, there is somebody in your life that was a false love, that was a pretend, that was a deceiver, that was taking and not giving, and that their mask is finally coming off, and it shocked you. It 100% shocked you. That's where this energy, and it could be, this could be energy coming back from the past, because it's like a retrograde is going to seriously impact you and affect you. It's almost like reliving the worst moment of your life this coming week. And if that's what's happening, Pisces, there's this energy of it's happening for a reason, sort of to remember, or to maybe because people are asking you about it, or you have to describe it, or go like relive a part of you that you just wanted to never ever talk about or think about again. Like having to go through this, that could be really cathartic experience for you, and you could be actually submitting yourself to this intentionally so that you can sort of break the leg to heal it the correct way, because you acknowledge that something had healed wrong and now you're sort of like breaking that leg to reset it. But there's definitely this energy of maybe this is intentional, because all of these cards are reversed. You could be having intentionally decided to flip yourself upside down because you're in such a good spot right now. You can actually take the emotional stress, because finally you're ready to go through this and relive this trauma so that you can actually move on from it. I really hope that that is the case, Pisces, and not just that your whole life is freaking falling apart. So let's get one more card, please. Let's get one more card from, Reclaim Your Power. And what did, oh, honey, I'm so sorry. Oh, more cards fell on my little puppy. Okay, honey, I love this. Okay, what card came out? Reclaim Your Power. This is the first card that was upright, and what it does is confirm my suspicion. You have done this intentionally. You are allowing yourself to relive a trauma so that you can literally break that bone again, intentionally inflicting these memories and these painful experiences on yourself, because now you are prepared to face them and take back your power. You are finally ready. This is that energy of fierce determination, of ferocity that many people don't know Pisces are capable of, but they absolutely are. Full commitment, determination, because you are, this is your power moment. You're ready to move forward. You're ready to bulldoze through all of this trauma and basically tear it all down to basically start all over, repave it, and sell it and walk away from it. But there's this energy of, no, I'm taking myself back. So yes, I was deceived, and yes, I was hurt, and yes, I was put through the ringer and really freaking just effed by somebody that was really, really close to me and should have had my back, but they didn't, and they were false to me. This came out of the blue. I had to deal with this trauma and this pain, and it stuck in my craw for the longest time. And now I'm going through it and reliving it all. You're doing it intentionally. You're literally, that's why all the cards are reversed, because you did it intentionally. You're intentionally turning your life upside down to get to empty out all your pockets and sift through all the crap in them. There's a bunch of cards that came out over here. Take time out to make your dreams real. This is you being a bear. This is you making a decision, coming to the surface. Your ferocity is coming to the surface so that you can reconstruct the world in the likeness that you want it. Spirit absolutely has your back. See, I kind of felt like, what is this? Why is this such a bad week for Pisces? But it's really not. It's really not. This is controlled pain and trauma in a weird way. Spirit has your back. Change is coming. Forward motion, forward progress, hard work, determination, maybe even monetary gain. Claim your independence from these things that have torn you up and held you down for so long. Sing your own song, getting back to yourself, being who you are, being fierce and ferocious and delicate, basically being able to be light again, to be light and airy and fresh and happy and balanced, because the energy of 1 + 2 = 3. And then last but not least, finding your peace. Pisces, you are literally reforming yourself. You have decided to knock on the doors of hell, to walk through it, to face all your demons. You've done this intentionally, and I think it's because you know intuitively you're about to blow up and explode, and you want a full person. You don't want to be vulnerable or susceptible to what all these hidden demons will make you susceptible to. So you're like, well, then I'm going to face them. This is the time, because everything else is going really, really well. Let me flip around the camera angle. We'll review the cards. Hold on. I am so glad I kept on reading. So glad. It was looking kind of glum. It was. But do you see what I'm saying? So these cards came out. These cards came out after the fact. These were the main cards for the reading. And everything was turned upside down. I'm like, what is happening? There was consciousness behind those cards turning themselves upside down. You have done this to yourself. You have held yourself back. You have ripped yourself apart. You have made yourself vulnerable. You have drained yourself. You've made yourself susceptible to all this past hurt and the suffering that this particular person, there is a particular person that was just a piece of doo-doo in your life, and they made you hurt, sideswiped you and caused you a lot of trauma, like literally stuck you with a sense of something that stuck with you that you haven't been able to let go of, that you've made bad judgments because of, that you've judged other people and other circumstances off of, that you've closed yourself off because of this trauma. This is the energy of literally that disconnected you from spirit and truth. And you're done with that. You are reclaiming your power by reliving all of this to confront it and get over it. It's almost like you're expelling the demon. You're, no matter how much it hurts, that's what's going to happen, because this is where you're headed. Back to lightness and happiness. Both energy. Do you see how they're, oh my God. Oh my God. This is 12 and this is 21. 100% rebalancing yourself. This is going to work, Pisces. This is going to work. This is brilliance beyond compare. And it's going to actually bring you back to a state of completion and wholeness and freedom. Freedom, literally, like you're starting a whole new life. Balance is coming back. Divine intervention coming in, like the spirit coming in to connect you and sit on your shoulder, to attach yourself to it, just be lighter and free and happy, and finally being able to be realized and sing your song out loud, whoever is watching. But yeah, it's liberation and peace is what it is. Let's see what comes after this. Are you curious about the extended? Well, the link is below, and I can't wait to see what's in your future and where this all goes. And after this week, you're going to deserve something beautiful. So Pisces, let's get this going. Show on the road. I'll see you over in the extended, and I'll do your romance reading. Bye.